Welcome. Simulating autoregressive models, autoregressive moving average models, moving average models using Excel. That's what we are going to discuss here. We are going to discuss here only ARMA models. Whenever your series is stationary, we'll discuss what is stationary, what is non-stationary at some other stage. At the moment, we are going to understand how to simulate AR model, how to simulate AR2 model, how to simulate moving average model order 1. How do we determine these orders? That we have already discussed at some other stage, or we'll discuss in some other video. So first of all, I am going to generate normal random numbers. If you are using 2016 or updated version, you should write norm.s.inv, and if you are using previous version, you can write norms inverse. So probability, when I write rand inside this, it means it's generating random numbers between 0 and 1, and it's a probability, and now we'll get z values. So we just get 10 values here. I'll extend it later on for up to 100 values, and I'm going to generate AR1 model. AR1 model means autoregressive order 1. Auto means self. So you are regressing on its own past values. Since y1 is equal to 0.7, y naught. Since we don't have y naught values, so we can use either average of these values, or we can use it as zero. So equal to 0.7 into y naught. What is y naught? Y naught we don't have. Plus et. What is et? This is et. Equal to 0.7 times y1. No, this is y2. This is y2, and this one is y1. So you can use this y1. So 0.7 times y1 plus e2, and now you can extend it. So you see, what is this one? If you look at this, so this is 0.7 times y8 plus e9, or because you have 10 values, so 10 values will be here up to this. We just make it up to 2 decimal places. Similarly, now we need to generate AR2 model, means autoregressive model of order 2. So what is equal to? This is 1.2 times y minus 1. We don't have that value. We are using here 0 or minus 0.7 times y naught, because this is yt, and its previous value y1 is equal to 1.2, y minus 1, yt minus 1. So y naught times y naught. Y naught we don't have, plus e1. Okay, next, equal to 1.2 times, since it is y2, so this will be y naught, and yt minus 1 will become y1. So this is 0 minus 0.7 times y1. What is y1? This is y1 plus e2. This is your e2, and if you extend it, one more value, 1.2 times this is y3, so yt minus 2 is y1. So this is your second leg, minus 0.7 times y1 plus e3, and you can extend it. So next, moving average order 1. Moving average model means that your yt is expressed as a function of past errors or past innovations or past disturbances, it's not the same as central moving average. So we'll discuss it at some other stage. Again, this the same concept, but this moving average should not be confused with the one which we use central moving average as in my previous Excel video. So ET. So again, ET is E1, Y1 is equal to E1 plus 0.7 E0. Again, if you don't have E0, okay, it's not an issue. Or you can generate E0 at your own. Enter equal to E2 plus 0.7. Please be careful. Here we cannot use this one. This is basically lag of Y. This is your E1. This is your E1. And now you can extend it. So you can extend it when you have this angry black rabbit. You can double click, and now you can take it up to 100, 101 values. You can plot it to get the idea. 101, and now we can just double click it and we can get the same values here. This is AR1, this is AR2. I'm going to complete it. Just one more thing. No, you see, I'm going to plot this one. Alt N1. I have plotted this one. So this seems, you see, a stationary series around mean zero and okay. But if I change this 0.7, if I change this 0.7 to 0.98, what happens? You see, this series is start converging towards, oh, now this is becoming non-stationary. So that's what is unit root testing, whether this coefficient is 1 or this coefficient is less than 1, between minus 1 and plus 1. When I put it 0.2 and I do it for whole data, it looks quite stationary. When this value 0.2 goes towards 1, it becomes non-stationary. When it becomes towards close to zero, it becomes stationary. So now you can have this one, and control tilde will give you the formula. So this is the formula. Control, if you press control tilde, you'll get this. And if you want to go back, you can have. We'll discuss this simulation using R as well, and how to estimate, how to make correlogram, how to make autocorrelation function, partial autocorrelation function to diagnose whether it is AR1 model, whether it is AR2 model, whether, because you will be given data and you have to guess whether it's AR1, whether it's AR2, whether it's MA1, ARMA11. Those that we'll study in our coming videos. Thank you for watching. Take care.